Hello sustainable growers, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. Today we're going to talk about the greenhouse in aquaponics. Are they important for aquaponics and do we really need a greenhouse to grow food in aquaponics? Before anything, if you want to help this channel to grow, please give me a like. Don't forget to get the 6-step aquaponics guide from the description of this video. And to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet. So I often receive the question, do I need a greenhouse to grow food in aquaponics? And here in this video, we're going to see what are the advantages of having a greenhouse and is it really, really important. So if you look behind me, you can see that I got some aquaponics setup without greenhouse. So first, it responds to your question. You can grow food without greenhouse in aquaponics. So you know that vegetables, they need several things to be able to grow. There are different factors that are going to have an action, an impact on the growth. And the most important factors are the light and the temperature. Obviously, you got the availability in terms of nutrient and water, but in aquaponics, we always got a good source of nutrient thanks to the fish. And we always got a good supply of water because thanks to the water pump and the bell siphon. So for those two specific factors, the plants are in the best conditions in aquaponics, in an aquaponic setup that is well managed. Now, the two other factors, the temperature and the light, they are depending on where you live and the weather, you know, the climate, the sun, the quantity of light that you're going to have are completely dependent of the area where you live. So here, for example, in our aquaponic setup, we got so many vegetables that are in the best conditions that they are always competing for sun. They're always trying to get the sunlight. And if you look in a grow bed aquaponics, the plants are always trying to grow in height to get the light because there is a competition between all those plants. Now, if you have a greenhouse around, when the sun goes to the greenhouse, depending on the material of the greenhouse, but most of the greenhouse, they cut, or they spread the sun ray. You know, the sun ray is coming out with a certain angle. And so only the plants from the top can have access to this to the sun ray, right, to the light. And the plants that are underneath, they are a bit more in the dark, so they don't have access to a good yield of sunlight. Now in a greenhouse, because you got the wall of the greenhouse, so most of the time it's plastic. When the sun ray goes to this plastic, the angle of the sun ray then is divided in a lot of different rays. So the light is more diffuse. You got light coming from everywhere, and therefore, even the plants that are on the bottom, they get the light from the sides of the greenhouse. So in terms of light, a greenhouse is really helping your crop to grow a bit more regularly, you know, to compete a bit less for light because the light is coming from all the sides. So it really helps from this point of view. There is also the possibility in a greenhouse to add some artificial light. I don't really recommend it because it decreases the sustainability of the setup. But then if it really increases the yield of your aquaponics, if you are in commercial aquaponics, it may be an option, especially if those lights are the power of those lights comes from a solar setup or a clean source of energy. The other point that is very important in a greenhouse to understand, and that's the point I would say, is obviously the temperature. You know that here, when you got your aquaponics setup outside, the temperature of the water is going to vary a lot, but also the temperature of the air around, right? So all the vegetables, they have direct access to the air, and the temperature of the plant is going to be the temperature of the air that you have outside. So here you got a lot of variations, but if it's in a greenhouse, the greenhouse kind of traps the air and allows you to have a temperature that is a bit higher. So you're going to maintain your system at a higher temperature. And as you know, the vegetables, if you put them in a higher temperature, most of them, they're going to grow way faster because their metabolism, their growth is dependent on the temperature of the air and of the temperature of the water. So it's the same thing for the fish. If you are in a greenhouse, most of the time you got your water temperature that is going to be higher. And if the water temperature is higher, then your fish are going to grow way faster. So that's also a very good point in a greenhouse. Your fish are going to grow faster, your vegetables are going to grow faster. So you understand here that having a greenhouse around your aquaponic setup is going to boost the production of the aquaponic setup, and therefore you're going to produce more efficiency and more sustainability. So that's really something that I recommend if you have the possibility to do it. If you have a very small aquaponic setup, it may not be worth it to put it in a greenhouse. If you have the possibility, I definitely recommend to put your aquaponic setup in a greenhouse. Now, if you want to go for commercial aquaponics, that's something that is even more important, because here the yield and the production of your aquaponic setup is going to be the most important part of the aquaponics adventure. So please go for it. Now, if your budget is limited, then you don't have to have a greenhouse. You know, you can have aquaponics without the greenhouse. It's going to work perfectly. It's going to produce some food with a yield that can be quite impressive. But again, if you can afford a greenhouse, it's going to boost it, and it's going to improve the yield, improve the efficiency of your aquaponic setup. So I hope that this video gives you a good guidance. Even if you are in a cold area, I come from France where the weather is not always the best. Even there, you can have an aquaponic setup without a greenhouse. But again, there, during the winter season, you will not be able to grow much fins. And you know, when you got the snow, basically you don't do anything. So you got a long period of time where you don't have any growth and where you need to maintain the setup. So it's much better to put it in a greenhouse. There is something that is important to consider and to keep in mind, is that if you are in a hot country, in a country where the weather, the temperature can increase up to 30 degrees or more, it's important to have a greenhouse where you are able to open the door sometimes to times, or to open some windows. And it's going to allow the air to circulate, because there is something you don't want, is the air into the greenhouse to be so hot that all the vegetables and the fish are dying. So there is also a limit into the maximum temperatures that you want into the greenhouse. Maintaining the temperature around 25 degrees is the target. But if you go over, then you can get some greenhouse with some specific windows and doors that are going to allow the air to breathe. And then if you are in a commercial aquaponic setup, you can always put some fans to really regulate the temperature. The fans are going to be linked to a thermometer, and when the temperature reaches a certain limit, it's going to turn the fans on, and they're going to circulate the air, so it's going to cool down the temperature. A last thing that is really for commercial this time, it's if you have a commercial aquaponics, you know that the plants, the vegetables, they breathe like us, so they consume some oxygen and they reject some CO2, but most of the activity is the photosynthesis during the day, and this phenomenon consumes some CO2 and rejects some oxygen. So if you close your greenhouse, your vegetables are not going to be able to find enough CO2, and therefore they are not going to be able to do their job and to grow properly. So then you can sometimes supply some CO2 into the greenhouse if you are in a closed environment, if it's cold outside, if you want to avoid to renew the air. But most of the time, if you have some problem of CO2, if you don't have enough CO2, you just need to aerate a bit the air into the greenhouse, and in this case you're going to drag some new CO2 into the greenhouse. So that was very specific to commercial aquaponics. For all the normal setups, normally you don't have a yield that is going to consume so much CO2 that is going to be a problem. So that's really very specific particularities of commercial aquaponics. Don't forget to get the free bonus from the description of this video. We got obviously the six-step guide to help you to build your own aquaponics setup in the best condition. So I spend a lot of time designing this little guide, so please get it and use it when you want to build your own aquaponics setup. It's going to give you some really good advice, very important, to make sure that the setup that you're going to build is going to be built in good condition, is going to be efficient, and is going to be able to help you producing some very healthy, tasty, and local food. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.